गुड मॉर्निंग मिस।
गुड मॉर्निंग। ओके यू कैन टाइप योर अटेंडेंस नाउ। एवरीबॉडी प्लीज डाउन ऑन योर कैमरा।
जे प्रेजेंट रेटर।
ओके यू कैन टाइप नाउ। डिड यू कंप्लीट योर होमवर्क?
Yes, miss.
But I have got only 4 responses. 4 or 5 responses. What about others?
Miss Vinshay, ipa kayyade ullu anna.
Okay. Then, latecomers also type your attendance now. Okay then, I think, do you have some doubts regarding to multiplication when the position changes? That is, when we multiply a whole number with a fraction, if either the position of whole number is first or second, that does not matter how the result is. Okay, that is, there was a question, that is, first one is, 2 into 1 by 5, and the third question was, sorry, 2 by 7 into 3 was first question, and the third question was 3 into 1 by 8, is it? Then some of you feel doubt regarding the position changes, that is, in the first question the whole number is in the second position, and in the third question the whole number is in the first position. Then you don't worry about that. You just look at, you have a one, you have a fraction, and you have a whole number. Then you just multiply the whole number with the numerator of a fraction part, and then replace the numerator and just keep our denominator as same. Okay. There is no changes you want to make. Then I think we are discussing about fraction as an operator of, is it?
Yes.
Okay. Shanif, Heaven and Halima, please turn on your camera. And I'm just going to share my screen. Latecomers, please mark your attendance, please. Okay. Okay, before that. Can you see this picture?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this is given in your textbook, page number 34. That is figure 2.6, is it? We were discussing about this picture. Okay, we have said that the above portion, there is 2 squares or 2 rectangles are given, and half portion of it is shaded. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, the half portion is shaded, that is, we, the fraction corresponding to this is 1/2 itself, each having 1/2 itself. Okay, that is, 1/2 portion of a rectangle is shaded, is it?
Yes.
Okay, here we get half the portion is shaded. I'm just drawing a rectangle here, and then you can see here, here is also a rectangle, and then I divide it into 2 parts. As you know, the one portion represents the fraction 1/2. Then what should be this portion? This is also
1/2.
This is also
1/2.
Okay. Then what would be represent the whole rectangle? What is the fraction which represents the whole rectangle? Which is 1/2 plus 1/2. Is it? 1/2 plus 1/2. And this 1/2 plus 1/2 can be replaced in the form of multiplication. Is it? How will you
yes.
replace? How will you replace?
2 into 1 by 2.
Yes, that's it. 2 into 1 by 2. So our whole portion or the whole rectangle is the product of 2 and 1 by 2. As we know, what is the product of 2 into 1 by 2? Which is
2 by 2.
Then what is the value of 2 by 2? What is the value? What is the value of 2 by 2?
1 by 2.
1
or 1 by 2? Which is the value?
1 by 2.
1 by 2.
How will you get 1 by 2? How will you get 1 by 2?
1 by 2.
It is 1. How will you get 1? Anybody please explain how will you get the answer as 1?
Multiple of 2.
Both 2s are multiples of 2. As we know, any number having the same denominator or any fraction having numerator and denominator same is 1 itself. Okay. 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 5 by 5, 6 by 6, 18 by 18, 50 by 50, and so on. If you have any fraction having same denominator and numerator, then its value should be 1. Okay. That's why we get the whole rectangle represents 1. Then 1 half of this 1 is 1 by 2 or 1 by 2 of 1. That is, what is 1 by 2 of 1?
Half of 1.
Okay, half of 1. Half of 1, and we can represent this specific area, is it?
Yes.
We can represent this specific area as, we can represent this specific area as 1 by 2 of 1. Play. This is half of this whole 1. That is 1 by 2 of 1. Then, what is the value of this specific area 1 by 2 of 1? As we have said earlier, it is 1 by 2.
1 by 2. 1 by 2.
Is it? That is 1 by 2 of 1 is equal to 1 by 2. We get 1 by 2 of 1 is equal to 1 by 2.
1 by 2.
Okay. Then what is the product of 1 by 2 and 1? What is the product of 1 by 2 and 1? What is the product?
1 into 1, 1.
If we multiply any number with 1, we will get the same number, is it?
1 by 2.
We get the answer as 1 by 2 itself. So, we know that 1 by 2 of 1 is 1 by 2. And 1 by 2 into 1 is also 1 by 2. That's why we can say that 1 by 2 of 1 represents the multiplication of 1 by 2 with 1. Is it clear? Delvin, do you have a doubt?
Yes.
Okay, just look at this picture. As we have said, this shaded region represents the half portion of this rectangle, is it?
Yes.
Okay, then the fraction corresponding to this shaded region is 1 by 2. And the fraction corresponding to the whole rectangle, that is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, which we have calculated as 1 or 2 by 2. Is it? So we can say that
yes.
1 by 2 of 1, that is half portion of this 1 is this 1 by 2. Is it? That
yes,
we have
sir.
Right here, that is 1 by 2 of 1 or half portion of this whole rectangle is equal to 1 by 2. Is it? And also we know the product of 1 by 2 and 1 is also 1 by 2. Okay, so both the RHS are same. If RHS are same, then LHS should be same. That is, half of 1 is equal to half into 1. From these two equations, we can write 1 by 2 of 1 is equal to 1 by 2 into 1. That itself. Okay, got it? Justice, yes. Do you have any doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
Heaven, what about you?
No, miss.
Vasudev. Okay. Okay. Look at, just look at this picture. Here we have a rectangle, is it? And then we have divided it into two equal parts. So here two parts and one of it is shaded. So we can represent it by the fraction 1/2. Is it clear for you?
Yes.
Okay. Then this region is 1/2, and we know that these are equal parts. Then this unshaded region is also represents the same fraction 1/2. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Yes, miss.
Okay.
Then what about the whole fraction? If we shaded the both portions, or we add these two 1/2 plus 1/2, this will represent the whole rectangle, is it?
Yes.
Then that we have done here, that is we are adding 1/2 plus 1/2. We know that 1/2 plus 1/2 can be written as 2 into 1/2, and the product of 2 and 1/2 is 2/2. 2/2 can be replaced by 1 itself. Okay. Then we get the whole rectangle as the fraction 2/2 or 1. So this whole rectangle represents 1. Is it?
Yes.
Okay. Then we have shaded the half portion of this 1. That is the half of 1 that we have written here. That is half of 1. We know that the half of 1 is 1/2 itself. That is, we are representing this shaded region as 1/2. So half of 1 is equal to 1/2. Is it? Also, we know that the product of 1/2 and 1 is 1/2 itself. So half of 1 is 1/2, and also 1/2 into 1 is equal to 1/2. From both these, we can write half of 1 is equal to 1/2 into 1. Is it clear now? Okay, yes, then don't worry. You can see in your textbook, there is a bottom part. There is, in the upper part, there are two rectangles like this. Is it? There are two rectangles like this. That is, I'm just going to draw another rectangle. And also, we have to divide it into two equal parts. And I'm also going to shade this portion by again. And we know that again, these are similar rectangles, and again this shaded portion represents which fraction?
1/2.
Fraction. It is also 1/2. Is it? This is also 1/2. Then this unshaded portion is also representing 1/2 itself.
1/2.
Okay. Then here we have, how many shaded regions?
One.
Here, just a minute. Here we have one shaded region among one rectangle. Is it? Here we have two rectangles. Yeah. And each rectangle having one shaded region. And that shaded region represents the fraction 1/2. Is it?
Yes.
Okay, then what is the fraction corresponding to this sum, their sum? That is, here the fraction corresponding to
2 by 2.
I'm sorry. Here, the shaded region is 1 by 2, and here is also the shaded region is 1 by 2. Then their sum would be 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. Is it?
Yes. 2 by 2.
It should be
yes.
2 by 2. We get the answer as 2 by 2, and we know that the value of 2 by 2 is what is the value of
1.
1 itself that we have already said. So the sum of these two fractions or these two rectangles should be 1, and we can just draw their sum in the pictorial form that I am going to draw here, which is given in your textbook in your bottom part. Is it?
Yes.
Okay. Just a minute. Here we have to fill with shapes. Is it? There are two portions and they are shaded. I'm just going to draw a line too for separating these two figures. That is, here we have just drawn the product or the sum of these two rectangles. First two rectangles, is it? That we, you can see in your textbook page number 34, figure 2.6 in the bottom portion. Okay. That is, in the first case, we have two rectangles having each half portion is shaded. That is, we represent it by the fraction 1 by 2. And their sum is, we have calculated their sum, that is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, which is given as 2 by 2. 2 by 2 is 1 itself. And I have drawn here, that is 2 by 2 portion is shaded. That is, each portion is shaded. That is the sum of these two rectangles. Is it confusing for you? No. Vasudev. Delvin.
Yes, miss.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Then here we have the fraction corresponding to our third rectangle is 1 itself. Is it? Okay. That is, we have calculated the sum of these two rectangles. That is the whole portion of these two. And the half portion of this one and the half portion of this one. Is it? So we get?
Yes.
We get it as whole one. This very simple, that is 1 by 2 of 1 represents the half portion of this, that is 1 by 2 into 1. That of representation is multiplication itself. Okay, that is, in this case, this is 2 by 2 of 2. In this case, we can just say that in the third picture, it is half of two rectangles. Is it? It is the half of two rectangles. Here we have two rectangles and we have just chosen the half of them. That is the half of two rectangles. That is, here we have brought it as half of two. We get the half of two. What is the half of two? We can just replace off by multiplication.
One.
Multiplication. That is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into 2. Then what will we get? 1 by 2 into 2 is equal to 2 by 2. And we know that 2 by 2 is 1 itself. That is, here we get the whole portion shaded. One portion is shaded. That is, the whole is shaded. That is, simply we can say that of represents the multiplication. Fraction as an operator of, is it? We are discussing. That is, in that case, we can say that OF is multiplication itself. That's it. That is, OF is the, OF represents multiplication. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Take page number 35. Page number 35. You can see the a figure 2.7, is it?
Yes.
What happened in that figure? Instead of selecting two rectangles, there is three rectangles are chosen, having each having half portion shaded, is it?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Then what is the fraction corresponding to our first set? There are three rectangles and their fraction corresponding to each rectangle is?
1/2.
Very good. It is 1/2. Then we are to add this 1/2. How many times, Payal? How many times do you want to add this?
Three
times. Okay.
Three times.
We have to add this 1/2 three times. Then we know that we have to replace this addition by multiplication. How will you replace that? How will you replace?
3 × 1/2.
3 × 1/2. That means we are adding 3 × 1/2. Then we have to replace that 3 × 1/2 by 3 × 1/2. I'm just repeating this for those who are not attending our first class. Okay. Please listen carefully. That's why we just replacing this figure or this addition of 1/2 + 1/2 + 1/2 by 3 × 1/2. That we can write it as
3/2.
That is 1/2 + 1/2 + 1/2, which is equal to 3 × 1/2. What we have to do while multiplying a whole number and a fraction? We have to replace numerator product of 3 × 1, that is 3, and the denominator as 2 itself. So we get it as 3/2. In this picture, you can see the sum is represented as how they represent the sum. They are only represented as shaded portions, is it?
Yes, miss.
So what is that representation? What is the representation of that? How will you represent that picture into fraction form? Is it a proper fraction?
No, improper.
No.
Even in the form of a mixed fraction. Is it? You know that? The one single shaded portion represents 1/2. Is it? That we have said earlier. And in that figure, you can see that there is a whole portion, that is two portions together. That is 1/2 + 1/2. Then what will be it represent? That first square?
2/2.
It should be 2/2. Or simply, what is 2/2? Simply, what is
2 × 1/2? 2 × 1/2, 2/2.
2/2 can be replaced as?
1.
1.
What is?
1.
1.
2/2 is 1 itself. Okay. I'm just drawn a rectangle here. That is, and we have to draw for a separation here. Okay. So this, we know that the half portion is 1/2 and another portion is also 1/2. Then This whole figure represents 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. That is, you have said which is 2 by 2 and it is 2 by 2 is, what is 2 by 2?
1.
Is 1 itself. Is it? Okay. Then you can see there is another half portion is also along with that. Is it?
Yes, miss.
You can see?
Yes, miss.
Figure like this. Yes. Here we know that each portion is 1 by 2. That's why we can say that this is also 1 by 2.
Yes.
So we have add these two portions together, then we get it as a whole or it is 1. And you have another 1 by 2 is also together. Then what is the sum of 1 and 1 by 2? What is the sum?
1 by 2.
What is sum? Sum. We are just adding 1 and 1 by 2.
2 by
2. 1 and 1 by 2. By 2. We are adding, not multiplying or subtracting. We are just adding. And we here... What it is? It is a whole number and the denominators are not same. But we can just replace 1 by 2 by 2. Is it? We have said that 2 by 2 is 1 itself and 2 by 2 plus 1 by 2. What is the answer of 2 by 2 plus 1 by 2?
3 by 2.
It is 3 by 2. So our whole shaded portion represents 3 by 2. Is it? That is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. That's itself. That represents 3 by 2. That's given in your textbook. That figure. In this case, we are using the operator O. That is, in the first portion, that 1 by 2 of 1 is shaded. Is it? You have three rectangles having 1 by 2 of them is shaded. Is it? That is,
yes.
1 by 2 of 1. Then what represent 1 by 2 of 1? 1
half.
By 2 of 1. What is it?
Half of 1.
Half of 1. How will you represent it? It would be a multiplication. Is it? That is 1 by 2 into 1. Which is equal to 1 by 2 itself.
That 1 by 2.
Half
1 by
2. Portion of this rectangle is shaded. I think just change this color. That is, I'm just coloring it. Now you can see here half portion of this whole one is shaded with blue color. Is it? So that half,
yes,
of 1 is 1 by 2 itself. And we know that the each is half of a whole and half of this 1 is 1 by 2. That is, half of means, or 1 by 2 of 1 means 1 by 2 into 1 itself. You simply stretch on this, that of represents the operation multiplication. Of stands for multiplication. That's it. Okay, I think you just confused about these all figures and this representation, because this is 1 by 2 and half. That's why you get confused. You just remind one thing, that of stands for multiplication. You just replace this of with multiplication. Okay. For that,
okay,
there is a question given. What is that question? Arjun, please read the question. Farida has that question. Please read it out. Page number 35. Please read the question. Okay, justice, please.
Yes, miss.
Farida has 20 marbles. Reshma has 1/5 of the number of the marbles what Farida has. How many marbles Reshma has?
Okay.
As of multiplication.
Here, how many marbles Farida has?
22.
Farida has how many marbles? 20 marbles. 20. And we are given that how many marbles Reshma has? Reshma has
1/5.
1/5 of Reshma's marbles. Reshma having, or is it?
No, Miss Farida having.
Sorry, Farida having. So 1/5 of Farida's, that is given as Reshma's. So we know that. How will you replace this of?
Multiplication.
Multiplication. Is it? Then we have to replace this of by multiplication. And we know that Farida having 20 marbles. Is it?
Yes.
So
yes, miss.
We just have to replace 1/5 of 20. Okay. And then we know that of represent multiplication, and it is 1/5 into 20. Then here we get the product of a fraction and a whole number. Then how will you calculate the product of a fraction and a whole number?
1/20.
How will you calculate?
First, numerator.
What is the numerator?
1.
Is it 1? There is a whole number 20. Then 20. That is 20 is the numerator and 5 is the denominator. Okay. Then what is 20?
Answer.
What is the value of 20/5?
4.
It is 4. When we divide 20/5, we will get the answer as 4. So, how many marbles Reshma has?
4
marbles. So, here you just remind one thing. We have to replace this of by multiplication for finding the answer. Okay. Of stands for multiplication. That is the simpler form of this concept. Justus, do you have any doubt?
No.
Joanna? Do you have any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Harinand? Okay. Sri Vishnu?
No doubt, miss.
Okay. Delvin, Halima, Shanif? If you are all fine, please show me your thumb. Okay. Heaven, please turn on your camera. And Aradhya. Okay. I think you are all fine with the representation of OF. That is, OF stands for multiplication itself. And after that, there is another try this question for you. Can you tell that what is 1/2 of 10? What is 1/2 of 10?
5.
5. 10. How will you get 5. This 5? That is 1/2 of 10. Is it? 1/2 into 10 is 10/2. That is 10/2 is 5 itself. Okay, good. Then what is, can you tell what is 1/4 of 16?
4.
It is 4. Then how will you get this 4? You just multiplied 1/4 with 16.
16 by 4.
Okay. It is 4 itself. Then what is 2/5 of 25? 2/5 of 25. You have to multiply. Yes, it is. You have to multiply 2/5 with 25. Then the numerator becomes the product of 2 and 25. That is 50. Then 50 divided by 5. Then what is the answer?
10.
Okay, it is 10/12. So, I think you are all familiar with the replacement of off with multiplication, is it? Anybody have any doubt in the replacement of this off having multiplication?
No.
No. Heaven and Aradhya, please turn on your camera. And there is another question for you, that is example 5. In a class of 40 students, 1/5 of the total number of students like to study English and 2/5 of the total students like to study mathematics. And the remaining students like to study science. There are 40 students in that class. And how many of the students like to study English? 1/5 of the students would like to study English. Then what is the number of students like to study English?
2/5.
It is 2/5 of which number? Total number of students is 40. Total is equal to 40. And 1/5 of the students like to study English. What is 1/5 of 40?
8.
1/5 into 40. Then what is the answer? What is the answer of 1/5 into 40?
40/5.
It is 40/5 because 1 into 5 there is numerator 1. Okay. Then what is the answer of 40/5?
8.
It is 8. Then how many students like to study English? 8 students like to study English, is it?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Then, what about mathematics? There are 2/5 students are like to study mathematics. Then, 2/5 of 40 is equal to, what is 2/5 of 40? 2/5 is 40.
40.
Get?
18/5.
80/5. Then, how will you simplify this 80/5? It is? What it is? What it is? Is it 16?
Yes, 16.
Okay, it 16. Is 16 itself.
Yes.
1/5 of 40 is 8 and 2/5 of 40 is 16. That is 8 students are like to study English and 16 students are like to study mathematics. And there is one more question, that is the remaining student like to study science. Then what is the number of remaining students? There are
16.
40 students and among 8 like to study which subject? English, and 16 like to study mathematics. So there is total 21 students are like to study mathematics and English. Then what is the remaining number of students? That is 24. Is it?
Yes, 16.
It is?
Yes, miss.
16. So 16 students are like to study science. Is it?